Legal experts flag Hong Kong's use of vague terms in its new national security law. The city-state on Friday opened debates for the controversial measure, which officials eye to pass in weeks. The bill, containing measures against treason, espionage, and external interference, among others. Eric Lai, a fellow at Georgetown Center for Asian Law, warns the broad terms of offenses under the proposal could give government officials sweeping authority against individuals. Lai also believes the bill could further impact Hong Kong's status as a financial hub.
It seems the government almost ignores all of the recommendations from the opposing views during the consultation period. And there are much tougher sentencing if crimes are related to colluding with foreign forces. It seems the business worries on Hong Kong's future as a financial hub under the one country, two system framework would be more apparent after the passage of the bill.
Things are looking bleak for a potential ceasefire between Israel and Hamas before the holy month of Ramadan begins. U.S. President Joe Biden warns it would be tough to secure a truce by Ramadan, which may start as early as Sunday. Biden added he is worried about the possibility of violence in Israeli-annexed East Jerusalem as Ramadan approaches. Hamas's armed wing on Friday urged supporters to mobilize towards the Al-Aqsa Mosque compound in East Jerusalem, which has been a flashpoint for violence during Ramadan in the past years. Meanwhile, the Pentagon says Gaza residents will have to wait longer for desperately needed aid that will be coursed through a temporary port that will be built by the U.S. An official said establishing the port will take several weeks.
In terms of timing, we're working to set this up as quickly as possible, but we expect that it will take several weeks to plan and execute. Once operational, the actual amount of aid delivered will depend on many variables and will likely scale over time. However, we expect that deliveries via J-Lots could provide more than 2 million meals to the citizens of Gaza per day. We anticipate that it'll take over 1,000 U.S. forces to participate in building this capability. As far as time frame, as I mentioned, several weeks, likely up to 60 days in order to deploy the forces and construct the causeway and the pier.
The war that erupted in October last year has killed over 30,000 Palestinians. Some airlines in the Philippines are mounting all-female crew flights to show that women can carve their own path in a male-dominated industry. Jackie Pascual tells us more.
All-women crew flights were mounted by AirAsia Philippines in celebration of International Women's Day and the National Women's Month. The airline says it is their way to push for gender equality and inclusivity, especially in a male-dominated industry. Captain Jasmine Timola is proud to be one of the few female pilots in the country today, and she admits that some passengers are still shocked to know she was their captain.
When I always get out of the cockpit, no? So some male passengers of us, oh, female! The aircraft doesn't know any gender. It's really both for men and women and every gender.
Timola and First Officer Nicolette Castañeda are both full-time moms. They say it's challenging to balance work and motherhood, but it can be done.
Having a toddler who is very clingy and yet you're gonna be flying, the separation anxiety is there.
I think it's very significant that we have flights like this, that it's all women,
yes,
to encourage others also that all women can do anything.
The cabin crew also shares having an all-women crew flight can be an inspiration to the public, especially to those who want to enter the industry. They say they are proof that women can do anything.
Pagka nalalaman nila na female pilot yung captain namin, nagugulat sila, ina-inspire sila to take a photo with them as well. Kasi yung kids nila, they also want to be a pilot.
Also have to have brains and beauties and also the courage. If in case kasi of emergency, syempre hindi pwedeng, maganda lang ako.
Flag carrier Philippine Airlines has also mounted all-women crew flights to the U.S., Vietnam, and many other destinations. Captain Lilibet Nang says it was very challenging when women started joining flying schools a few decades ago, but they have long proven that women are competent and capable as their male peers.
It's the same as driving a car. Before, there were no females, and maybe male passengers were, or in general, passengers were afraid of female drivers. It's a matter of perception.
Former pilot Amy Carandang Gloria, the first female captain in a commercial airline in Southeast Asia, joined the send-off ceremony for the women crew. And she is happy that more women have joined the sector.
When I stand before you today, I see not just pilots, but future leaders who will continue to inspire generations to come.
The airlines hope to hire more women as pilots. Currently, women pilots comprise 12% of PAL pilots and 10% of AirAsia pilots. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
As the Philippines celebrates Women's Month, one of the remarkable female leaders in the tech field hails women's capability to manage multiple roles in society. Speaking to ANC's Business Outlook, NetTrust Philippines Chairwoman and CEO and a mother of four, Jen Capones Tongco, asserts women can thrive both at home and in workplaces without feeling like they should be confined to just one role.
You don't need to choose. You can have both ambition in terms of whatever fuels your passion in terms of your ambition. And being a mom, I think it's really more of understanding that we cannot do it all, mm-hmm. right? Because sometimes women are hard on themselves, saying that, you know, I have to do it all. And that's the reason why that stops them from doing what they want to do. There are so many things that people may say. And the way for me to move forward and to be able to have success is not to really mind all these things, but control what I can control, which means taking charge of my career or what I can do, founding my own company, taking the seat on the table.
The Philippine Coast Guard accuses China of spreading baseless claims over the latest maritime incident in the West Philippine Sea. PCG spokesperson Jay Tariela says Beijing is misinterpreting the incident by claiming or misrepresenting the incident by claiming the Philippine side is the aggressor. But Tariela maintains Manila's transparency initiative has repeatedly shown that China has been harassing Philippine vessels even within the country's exclusive economic zone.
Despite of all this provocation na na-document natin, sinapubliko natin, and it was also captured by the international media. And yet, ang Chinese government, sila pa ngayon nagpapalabas na we are the ones na nag-escalate ng tension, nag-trespass daw. This is the reason why the Philippine government is really doing its effort in our transparency strategy.
An analyst warns China may further escalate tensions in the South China Sea following the call of its leader Xi Jinping to the military to prepare for war. Maritime security expert and international studies professor Renato De Castro says Beijing could further flex its naval might to assert control over the disputed waters.
Bakit po napakalakas ng loob ng China dyan? Sa ngayon ho, ang China ho ang merong pinakamalaking navy. Pinahu nila ang Estados Unidos.
Huh?
Meron na ho sila around 450 ships ng People's Liberation Army's Navy, samantala ang Estados Unidos ho, nasa mga 250 lang. Kaya napakalakas ho talaga ng loob nila. Itong nakaraang araw lang ho, in-announce ho, meron ng party congress na nangyayari. Doon sa party congress ho, pinulong ho ni President Xi Jinping yung military commission, yung member ng military commission, at sinabi niya, maghanda tayo sa digmaan sa karagatan. Pananakop po ng China, dapat paalisin ho nila lahat yung mga barko dyan, ang Philippine Navy, ating mga mangisda, and even yung Coast Guard natin. So nakikita natin talaga yung tinutuloy ho nila, yung kanilang objective is of course maritime expansion.
But despite this, De Castro is convinced the Philippines should continue its transparency initiative to show that Manila is standing up against Beijing's aggression.
Dapat po natin ituloy kasi pag hindi po natin ituloy yan, tinatanggap po natin yung pananakop po nila. Kumbaga, we agree na kanila yan. At of course, hindi rin tayo papayag ho na humingi sa kanila ng permission. We have to assert yung karapatan natin as provided by UNCLOS at ipamukha rin ho sa buong mundo na hindi natin tinatanggap at dapat rin ho nila hindi tanggapin yung pananakop po ng China. Kasi pag bumigay ho tayo, sasabihin ho ng buong mundo, oh, tinanggap nyo na yung pananakop ng China, di ano pa magagawa natin?
The camp of embattled televangelist Apollo Quiboloy has advised the House Committee on Legislative Franchises that their client does not have the information the panel needs in its hearings. This was in response to the subpoena issued by the panel to compel Quiboloy to attend a congressional investigation into the alleged franchise violations of SMNI. According to Quiboloy's lawyers, the pastor has not been involved in the management and operations of SMNI since 2018. They add the only title Quiboloy holds in the company is honorary chairman, which doesn't have any official function. The House panel's chairman, Gustavo Tambunting, however, said it is within the discretion of Congress to subpoena any person. Now he believes Quiboloy can best answer the questions posed in the inquiry. The committee resumes its hearings on March 12. President Marcos will visit Europe next week to meet with high-level officials in Germany and the Czech Republic. Aside from exploring trade and investment opportunities, the president is also looking to expand defense cooperation with the two European countries. Joyce Balancho has details.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. will depart on Monday for a working visit to Germany on March 12 to 13 to be followed by a state visit to the Czech Republic on the 14th up to the 15th. The president will meet with German Chancellor Olaf Scholz in Berlin, while in the Czech Republic, he will meet with the four heads of the Czech government, including its prime minister, the parliament senate president, and the president of Chamber of Deputies. Department of Foreign Affairs Assistant Secretary Maria Elena Algabis said his trip seeks to strengthen bilateral relations and foster increased cooperation with the two nations. Several agreements are expected to be sealed during the president's visit to Germany, including a cooperation in the maritime sector as well as technical and vocational education and training. While in the Czech Republic, President Marcos is expected to witness the signing of a joint communique on the establishment of labor consultations mechanism. Now, this aims to enhance cooperation for the safe and orderly migration of Filipino workers as well as protection of their rights and welfare. DFA said there are around 7,000 Filipinos in the Czech Republic, and the government there has expressed great interest to invite more Filipinos as they commend them for their talent, skills, good work ethics, and hospitable nature. Possible discussions on rules-based international order as well as the South China Sea issue are also possible with the leaders of the two countries. ASEC Algabre said Philippines has an existing maritime cooperation with Germany, and it is expected that the two nations will discuss further expansion of that cooperation. President Marcos Stanley will also meet with prominent business leaders in both countries to bolster trade and investment opportunities. There will be meetings with companies that are in the renewable energy, manufacturing, healthcare, aerospace, and innovation. Now, just like in his previous foreign travels, Marcos Jr. is also expected to face the Filipino communities living in Germany and the Czech Republic to personally share his administration's plans and programs for the OFW and to reaffirm the government's commitment to continuously support Filipinos worldwide. Pala said the two visits coincide with the celebration of the 70th anniversary of diplomatic relations with Germany this year and the 50th anniversary of bilateral relations with the Czech Republic last year. The president will be joined by First Lady Liza Marcos, House Speaker Martin Romualdez, Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, and some key cabinet officials, including Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo, Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual, Agriculture Secretary Francisco Chu Laurel, Migrant Workers Officer in Charge Hans Leo Cacdac, among others.